Is this art? Can't sell it. I'm Bridget Polk, and I'm here at Lafayette Anticipation for the Coming Soon exhibit, and I balance rocks and rubble. My point of view with them is that the future doesn't exist, and these are pieces that we can look at and enjoy, and knowing that they're going to fall. And the theme for me, or what I hope people understand, is that when they fall, it's kind of exciting, it's good, and they fall, and it's okay, because we'll come back, I'll come back and do another one. And the important message is to enjoy them while they're there, and not worry about when they fall. Meditation. Because the way I learned a simple way to define meditation is stillness, silence, and focus on one thing. Of course, I have to move to make the balance happen. I'm silent, and I am focused on the point of contact and the three points within the point of contact that I have to make the top piece find to stop moving. When I used to do it by the river, I thought of it as a way to not get bored while I was meditating. And now what I really enjoy is sometimes people come into that meditative space, maybe not, you know, completely into a meditation, but that idea comes. When I teach people to do it, they do it for the first time, and I say, okay, so you still use that? I said, you are meditating. So it's my secret stealthy way to teach people how to meditate. Making the bass is strong work. I have an assistant, Josephine, who I couldn't do this without her, because I've had some health issues and I need the strength of another person to help me with the basses. But it's kind of brutal. You know, we're putting it over here and putting this on top. And then when we get to the top one, it's like, I go, thank you very much. And she goes to the side. And I'm barely moving it. I've seen video of me doing the top piece, and it looks like I'm just standing there, just waiting for, you know, it to stick. But I'm moving it so little. So I would say that maybe a gesture is, we start with the difficult tasks of building our foundation. If we build a strong one, we're more likely to have some ease at the top. So once I feel it stop, I know I'm done. And then I go. It's pretty much just simply not speaking. And there are certainly different layers of silence. When I'm doing this out in nature, it's silent, except sometimes I'll stop and I say, I hear five things. I hear 10 things, five different birds, the water, so the silence in nature, I don't think really happens. I have a stillness and silence about me that I have to be able to do the thing. And when people come, sometimes people come to me after I do a piece and they're like, thank you so much. I thought about my grandfather who did, and I realized, and thank you. And I say, you're welcome, but that wasn't me. That was because, when was the last time you stood still and watched and were quiet and for 20 minutes, however long that took? So people realize how much the stillness and silence means as far as them realizing something. It's not something outside themselves, it's within You can do it. It's not magic.